Is there a way we can make Eeloo a summer destination? What would we need to heat up the planet? Well, hold on. Is the planet? Anyways, what would we need to heat up Eeloo to a comfortable 293 Kelvin or 20 degrees Celsius? Well, this idea for a video was proposed by one of you, and the proposed solution was an enormous lens. How big would this lens need to be to heat up Eeloo significantly? As most of you probably know, lenses can collect light and then focus it into a so-called focal point. Due to the fact that you can suddenly project so much energy in one place, you can actually let things catch on fire with something like a magnifying glass. The bigger the lens, the more light it can collect, and thus the more energy to heat up something like Eeloo. But to calculate how big this lens would need to be, we need to start with an equation that should look familiar to those who have been watching my videos for a while. The planetary equilibrium temperature equation. This equation lets you calculate the surface temperature of a planet, assuming that the only source of energy is the star that the planet is orbiting, in this case, Kerbal. T star is the temperature of the star, R star is the radius of the star, A is the reflectivity of the planet, or what we call albedo, and lowercase a is the semi-major axis of the planet's orbit. Okay, to show you how this works, we know all the variables in the case of Mars. So according to this equation, the equilibrium temperature should be about 210 Kelvin. And as it turns out, the average surface temperature of Mars is also about 210 Kelvin. Now, if a planet has a thicker atmosphere, it can trap the heat more efficiently, and thus it would result in a higher temperature than calculated. Eeloo has no atmosphere, so that makes things a lot easier. But how is this going to help us? It says nothing about a possible lens. Well, to understand the equation that we need to calculate the size of the lens, we need to know where this equation comes from. Don't worry, it's not gonna be as complicated as last time. If you have a planet in thermal equilibrium, that means that the energy absorbed by the planet is the same as the amount of energy being emitted. It has found a balance. In this case, the energy going into the planet comes from the star, and the energy leaving the planet is lost thermally through this expression. Normally, we can just rewrite this equation to get the regular equilibrium temperature equation, but that is not what we want, because it says nothing about the size of a lens. This left side of the equation says how much energy is hitting the planet. L is the total power of the star, but only a fraction reaches the planet. Imagine at a distance A from the star, the light will have spread across the area of a sphere. Now, the bigger the planet, the more light it can catch. So the ratio between the light caught and the total light being emitted is the frontal area of the planet divided by the area of the sphere. Now we have the fraction of light emitted by the star that is actually reaching the planet. Additionally, we had this reflectivity thing. Imagine a planet has an albedo of 0.9. That means it reflects 90% of the light hitting it. That energy will not be absorbed and thus not heat up the planet. So that would reduce the amount of power on the left side of this equation. But if we have a lens collecting the light for us, it's not just these beams of light that will reach the planet, but also the light that would normally pass around it, if the lens is big enough. So, this area is not the frontal area of the planet, but that of a lens. And thus we suddenly have the equation for the size of the lens. Now, making this video, I did not want to bother with optics or anything like that. Of course, a fraction of the light hitting the lens will be absorbed and such. If anything, this equation shows what the minimum size of our lens should be. If anyone familiar with this kind of physics is watching, I would love to know what you think about this approach that I have here. It feels right what I'm doing, but I'm not sure. It's an idealized situation, but the idea seems reasonable to me. Instead of having a frontal area of the planet catching the light, we have an entire lens doing the job. With some rewriting, we get an expression for the radius of the lens. So what would be the size of the lens if we want a surface temperature of 293 Kelvin? Well, plug this all in and we get a lens with a radius of about 2.7 million meters, which is about half the size of the Joule. So that is absolutely ridiculous. I don't think Kerbals are going to be capable of that anytime soon. By the way, memberships are now a thing on the channel. There are three tiers, each with their own perks, like badges and emojis. I also have a few video ideas in the barrel, so those are certainly coming soon. I want to upload once every 2 weeks at the very least for now. If you want to support that, then please consider getting a membership and click the link down below where we'll explain all the perks. If you have another crazy idea, like the one discussed in this video, please let me know. Maybe I will tackle it in a video soon.